Hello, listener. So I pretty rarely do this, discussing current events and so on, because I think making a video on current events will render it pretty much irrelevant within a week or so, and then when someone goes back to look at what you're talking about, what your ideas are, it's all old content that they won't be interested in. But I wanted to talk about the OK Boomer thing, because I think that it's interesting in some ways. So firstly, it's suddenly become a left-wing meme, the OK Boomer meme. It had been a right-wing meme on 4chan and online circles, Twitter groups and so on for about 2 years, maybe even longer by now. And this year it won, Boomer became Word of the Year in the Netherlands. And I was listening to the radio while driving, and the explanation they gave was, okay, boomer is a dismissal of people with old-fashioned and conservative ideas. A boomer is someone who is spiritually old-fashioned. And I was thinking, what a ridiculous twist of the okay boomer meme, because you can say a lot about boomers, but you can't really accuse their generation of being conservative in any way, or old-fashioned. The reason that the right, the nationalists, had this okay boomer meme is because we were criticizing them for being so progressive. After all, they were the generation of 1968. They are the generation of cultural Marxism. The boomer generation is the generation that introduced the secularization of politics. They introduced free sex. They introduced liberal drug policies. They, in general, they were the progressive generations. They were the hippies. They were the stoners. They're the generation of Woodstock, of what's that gonzo journalist. Anyway, there's nothing conservative or old-fashioned in any way that I can think of when referring to boomers. The criticism of boomers was always, you are the generation that broke with tradition, you're the generation that, you know, rather than passing on the traditions and the culture of your ancestors, chose to break away with it for ideological reasons, because you had some kind of complex about the Second World War or something, and maybe some of it was propagandized into you. But anyway, you decided to have this break with tradition and to have introduce all these experimental left-wing and liberal ideas into the culture, and they're the ones who created sort of the modern world, although the creation of the modern world has been a long process. But it accelerated markedly in the 1960s, in the 1970s, up to the point where we are today, where there's drag queen story hours, there's great pride marches throughout the entire month of July, you know, all these sorts of things. And another criticism for boomers was, of course, that they're the first generation ever, pretty much, to pass on no intergenerational wealth. They are such hedonists and egoists that they just consumed all the wealth that was passed on to them by their parents, and the wealth that they created, which was also quite a matter of circumstance, the post-war reconstruction, that unprecedented level of wealth. They have been the richest generation in history and will probably be the richest generation ever in history, because we see a downfall in the economic prospects of the successive generations, millennials, zoomers, and so on. So boomers are also just very egoistic and hedonistic, which is very reflective of the modern world, of course. So this idea that it's somehow an okay boomer as a criticism of a conservative traditional mindset of being old-fashioned, I don't see it. Boomers are the ones who introduced all this modern art in the art galleries, the famous pindakaas floor, where they smear peanut butter on the floor and they say, it's art, it's one of the most famous art pieces here in the Netherlands. Or Mondrian, or, no, Mondrian's earlier, but all this really disgusting, really bad art, like if you go to Tate Modern and you have a look around the art there, just garbage. I mean, the modern art of the 1920s was more interesting than this, right? You had Cubism, and you had Futurism, and you had Dali's Surrealism. At least it still had some ideas, and it still represented something, and the work was something actually creative. And this new modern art is like, oh, I've slashed a canvas, it's art, and I've or I've soiled a bed and put it on a stage. It's art. It's the conceptual, like Damien Hirst. Damien Hirst's work are some of the worst examples of this whole modern art thing. Fermenting pigs in a jar. Bam! It's art. Sells for hundreds of millions of dollars. Now, I can get into that, but the reason that modern art is so overvalued hasn't really anything to do with the intrinsic artistic value, but it has a lot to do with dodging taxes, but that's all secondary. So this whole okay boomer thing, it originated from the right. It was a logical critique from the right to the boomer generation for breaking with the traditions of their ancestors, for being hyper-consumerists, hyper-capitalists, and hyper-hedonists who selfishly guzzled up all the wealth from generations past and all the wealth created by technological progress. And basically, the boomer generation is extremely catabolic. Oil allowed us to maximize and really rapidly grow our economies in the post-war period. And we're now slowly starting to run out of oil. So basically, the boomer generation consumed up all the oil. They had cheap energy, and they used it to fuel their own base needs and desires for sex and drugs and big houses and holidays all over the planet. I mean, boomer generation, again, is the generation that came up with this absurd concept that you go on holidays 2 or 3 times a year anywhere in the world. That's not normal that people can just travel all around the world. The very fact how much that damages the environment, but then also the idea that anyone in the, you should be able to go anywhere in the world, that you should be welcome anywhere in the world. No, you're not welcome anywhere in the world. You're some globe-trotting, unwelcome guest treating the local culture as a curiosity rather than the authentic way that people live their lives and experience the world. Yeah, it's commodification of culture is what these holiday this whole idea of going on holidays, it's commodification of culture, consumption of resources completely needlessly. You can just as well have some nice time off by going camping in your own country, enjoying nature. Anyway, that's aside. Basically, the okay boomer meme from the left doesn't make any sense. It made a lot more sense when it was a right-wing meme, and it should really, of course, like whenever a meme is taken over from by the left from the right, usually it dies off. Like Pepe kind of died off, but came back when the left took over. The whole these reaction images and so on, memes die when they go to the mainstream or when the left takes them over because they're no longer funny. And they get misinterpreted, and the whole core idea is lost. And it's very much the same with the OK Boomer thing. You'll notice it's being spread around a lot more now, and it'll be incorrectly used all the time with this leftist context of, oh, OK Boomer is to dismiss someone who's saying something bad about, I don't know, Muslims or something. Which these people, those boomers who criticize Islam, do it from a liberal perspective, not because they have some sort of... They do it to protect the gays and to protect religious freedoms and so on. That's their motivation for it. It's not any authentic desire to maintain their own authentic selves or their own culture or to keep out foreign elements and to keep their own people homogenous. It's not an ethnic nationalism or anything like that. There's nothing like that to it. Geert Wilders, for example, he's constantly going on about Islam's bad because they want to kill the gays, which is the stupidest motivation to be against anything. Anyway, rant over.
Jugendstahl